وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I want to speak about Ramadan is the month of شهر الاستقامة, is the month of steadfastness. This is inshallah ta'ala what I want to shed some light on. The relationship and the bond between fasting and steadfastness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us about Ramadan. He says, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He tells us that Ramadan is the month which the Quran was sent down. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس, guidance for the people. And istiqama means guidance. It is to be consistent and continuous upon guidance. Ramadan teaches us to be steadfast and upright. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the hadith, Saddidu wa qaribu. Saddidu wa qaribu here means to be upright and steadfast upon the correct way. ولذلك the ayah, إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم. This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ, those who said Allah is our Lord. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, and they became steadfast. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, the angels will descend upon them. And the angels will say to them two things. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا, do not be scared of us. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا, and do not be worried and concerned for your family members and the people you've left behind in the dunya. وَأَبْشِرُوا, glad tidings. Because you're أَهْلُ الْإِسْتِقَامَةِ, you're from the people who are steadfast. There's nothing for you to be worried about. نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورِ الرَّحِيمِ, forgiveness of their Lord will be descending onto them. Umar radiallahu anhu recited this ayah in Surah Fussilat. He recited it on the pulpit, on the member. And when he recited it, he said the meaning of إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, those who said Allah is our Lord and they were steadfast, he said it means لَمْ يَرُوغُ رَوْغَانَ الثَّعْلَبُ, it is those people who do not deviate to the right and the left. Yani the straight. Because the fox is an animal that doesn't move straight. The fox, it looks right, it looks left, it keeps looking around. The people of istiqamah, they don't get distracted by those who are calling them on the right or those who are calling them on the left. And they're upon that path. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. They believe that the path is straight and they're on that path. That's why it's called Sirat al-Mustaqim, the straight path. The people of Istiqama, they stay upon that path. They don't go right or left. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as Sufyan ibn Abdullah al-Thaqafi said. He said, قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Sufyan ibn Abdullah al-Thaqafi said, I said to the Prophet of Allah. I spoke to the Prophet and I said to him, قُلْ لِي فِي الْإِسْلَامِ قَوْلًا. Say to me a statement regarding Islam. Say a speech to me about Islam. لا أسأله عنه أحدا بعدك, which I will not need to ask anyone after you. Say a statement to me regarding the religion. I can hold on to it, that I will not need anyone to say anything to me after you, O Messenger of Allah. The Prophet said to him, قال قل آمنت بالله ثم استقم. Say, I believe in Allah and be steadfast. It's exactly what the ayah mentioned. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ, those who said Allah is our Lord. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, and then they became steadfast. You said Allah is my Lord, then be steadfast on what you said. You said, Allah is my Lord. You say, I believe in Allah. Then be steadfast. Don't make it a mere claim. Istiqama, my beloved brothers and sisters. It's not just a mere claim. You can't just say, I believe in Allah, and that's it. Rather, you have to be steadfast. And then you being steadfast means you're upright in your speech and in your actions and what comes out of your mouth, and you're steadfast in your heart and everything. ولذلك the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told us, لا يستقيم إيمان عبد حتى يستقيم قلبه ولا يستقيم قلبه حتى يستقيم لسانه ولا يدخل الجنة رجل لا يأمن جاره بوائقه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, a person's iman is not going to be steadfast. Your iman is not going to be upright until your heart is upright, and your heart will not be upright until your tongue is upright. And a person will not enter Jannah until his neighbors are safe from his harm. He doesn't harm his neighbors. He doesn't harm the people around him. Safe. This hadith taught us that istiqamah comes from the heart, and it also comes from the tongue. So istiqamah is not just in the heart. As so many Muslims say, my heart is good. Stop judging me from the outside. You don't know what's in my heart. We say to that individual, istiqamatul qalb is one of the things. And the second one is istiqamatul lisan. Where is the steadfastness of your tongue? Where is the steadfastness of your limbs and your body parts? Who said that istiqamah is only in that heart? Who said steadfastness is only in the heart? Who said righteousness is only in the heart and not on the limbs? The Prophet told us in an authentic hadith, it's found in Sahih Muslim, in hadith Abi Hurairah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ أَجْسَامِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. Allah doesn't look at your forms and your physique and how big and how strong you are. What Allah looks at, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He observes, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is what's in your heart and what has manifested on your limbs. ولذلك الإمام مالك رحمه الله, he said, or it was said, that he said, أنه بلغه عن القاسم بن محمد. الإمام مالك, it reached him from Al-Qasim ibn Muhammad. Al-Imam Malik, it reached him that Al-Qasim ibn Muhammad said, أَدْرَقْتُ النَّاسَ وَمَا يُعْجِبُهُمُ الْقَوْلَ. I met a people. Al-Qasim ibn Muhammad is saying this. I met a people and speech did not fascinate them. يعني a person's eloquency and how he talks and what he says and how much he flexes his wordings and how silver-tongued he is. That doesn't fascinate. إِنَّمَا يُعْجِبُهُمُ الْعَمَلِ. What fascinated these people is the person's actions. Has the istiqamah come from his actions? Or is just a mere speech? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said a statement that deserves to be written in ink of gold. He said, أَعْظَمُ الْكَرَامَةِ لُزُومُ الْإِسْتِقَامَةِ أعظم الاستقامة أما أعظم الكرامة لزوم الاستقامة. The greatest honoring a person can gain, and the greatest way Allah can honor a person is by making this person consistent upon steadfastness. For Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, or for you to be honored, is that you're a steadfast person. Ramadan teaches us that. Ramadan is that month where we learn istiqamah. If we were not people who were steadfast and upright, Ramadan will teach us it. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Man sama Ramadana," anyone who fasts the month of Ramadan, "wa atba'ahu sittin min shawwalin," and he follows it up with what? He follows it up with 6 days of Shawwal, "fakannama sama ad-dahra." It's like you fasted the whole entire year. Steadfastness. You fasted Ramadan, you completed the month of Ramadan, you've done it and it's over, and then you followed it up with what? وَأَتْبَعَهُ سِتٍ مِّن شَوَّال. You follow it up with 6 days of Shawwal. That is what? That is you fasting the entire year. 6 days of Shawwal, the month of Ramadan, makes 1 year. Steadfastness. You didn't just start the fasting in Ramadan and finish, stop it. Naam. Shawwal comes in, You fast. And the person follows it up with those 6 days of Shawwal. Those 6 days, without a shadow of a doubt, they do not have to be consecutive. The person has to just do it within the month of Shawwal. They have to do it within the month of Shawwal. But consistency and continuation of fasting Ramadan and fasting the month after it, yani being consistent upon what you started and not stopping it, that's what Ramadan is teaching you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from Ahlul Istiqamah, those who are steadfast and upright in their religion and their statements and what they do. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.